No, I didn't grow up on that side of the town. No, my mama don't have no network. No, I don't know a whole lot of people. No, I'm not at a country club. No, I don't play golf, and I don't plan on playing no time soon. But I'm still gonna be successful. I'm still gonna get to where they are. Why? Because I owe it to myself. And can't nobody stop me but me. You need to get rid of them excuses, and you need to stop pointing fingers at people. And you need to start pointing fingers at yourself. What did you not do?
I'm here to tell you that in life, you're going to make mistakes. You're going to fail. You're going to pick the wrong boyfriend. You're going to pick the wrong girlfriend. You're going to choose the wrong major in college. You're going to get in an argument. You're going to lose the wrong job. You're going to make mistakes. That doesn't mean you still can't be successful. That don't mean you still can't be great.
If you look in the mirror and you don't like the way you look, do you get mad? Do you get frustrated? Or do you say, okay, I need a new outfit? I'm going to get in the gym this year. Right? You look in the mirror, that's what you're going to do, right? You go, I don't like what I see, I'm going to fix it. Ain't even no need for no other emotions, all right? Your life is the mirror to who you are on the inside. So if you don't like what's happening in your neighborhood, you fix it.
You owe you an explanation. You owe you an explanation. You need to look at yourself in the mirror and say, why are you only giving 50%? What's wrong with you? You need to put yourself on punishment. You need to tell you, no more TV, no more snacks, no more desserts, no more, no, we working out now. No more alcohol, not right now.
Everybody won't join you, that everybody won't have the vision. It's necessary to know that. That a lot of people like to complain, but they don't want to do anything about their situation. That you are an uncommon breed. You know, you have to know within yourself that I can do this. Even if no one else sees it for me, I must see it for myself. That's necessary. That in the process of working on your dreams, you are going to incur a lot of disappointment, a lot of failure, a lot of pain, a lot of setbacks, a lot of defeats. But in the process of doing that, you will discover some things about yourself that you don't know right now. What you will realize is that you have greatness within you. What you'll realize is that you're more powerful than you could ever begin to imagine.
Live your life like a GPS. You know when you program your route to your GPS? You know, if the GPS gets off course or you make a mistake, the GPS don't get an attitude, don't break down, don't go into a depression. It just says rebound. It just says rebound. Once you lock in that destination, it's going to get you there. Live your life like that. Once you lock in your destination, get there, no matter what. And again.
So I applaud you for your dreaming, for your running towards your dream. I applaud you for believing in yourself, because that's what life is about, stretching and challenging, looking for ways that you can begin to improve yourself. And ladies and gentlemen, as a result of stretching out, of acting on my dream, and I don't know what that dream is for you, I can tell you that it's possible.
For all of us, one day we're gonna be on our deathbed. And when you're on your deathbed, what you're not going to say is, man, I should have bought more stuff. You're not going to say, I should have had some more shirts with somebody else's name on it. Right? What you're going to say is, I wish I had spent more time with my family. I wish I never gave up singing. I wish I never gave up acting. Right? So Buddha talks about that the secret to life is to die before you die. To have that revelation while you're young enough to do something about it and live the life that you want to live and be who you want to be. Right? So don't forget that. Do something that you are passionate about and don't apologize for it.
Hilton said simply this, that if you want a thing bad enough to go out and fight for it, to work day and night for it, to give up your time, your peace, and your sleep for it, if all that you dream and scheme is about it, and life seems useless and worthless without it, and if you gladly sweat for it and fret for it and plan for it and lose all your terror of the opposition for it, and if you simply go after that thing that you want with all of your capacity, strength and sagacity, faith, hope, and confidence, and stern pertinacity, if neither cold poverty, famish, or cold, sickness, or pain, or body and brain can keep you away from the thing that you want, and grim. You besiege and beset it with the help of God you're getting.